Hey guys, welcome back to another tutorial. In today's video we are gonna make a basketball on Maya. So it's gonna be pretty simple. In this video I'm only going to show you how to model the basketball, and probably next week I'll be doing the texturing video. So let's start. The first thing we need to do is we're gonna create a sphere. So to do that, you have to come select the sphere over here on the polygons menu, and we're gonna create a sphere. Now let's center this sphere by giving a translate x of 0, y to 0 and z to 0. So it's gonna come right to the center. Now the next thing we need to do is let's click on 5 so that we may see the opaque shape. And down here on the inputs we're gonna select polysphere 1. And we're gonna give the radius of 5, subdivisions axis of 16, subdivisions height of 11. And this is going to be our basic shape. Now what we're going to do is we're going to create two curves over here, two curves by the two sides, kind of like a basketball. So you may see that that's the cross section. It's going to be a plus sign, and that's going to be two curves. So we're going to work on creating these two curves right now. So you have to come to the top view. Let's click on space, and then let's click on the top view space. Now let's right click and go to the edge selection tool. Now we are going to select these three edges. It's going to be right in the center of the circle of the sphere, sorry. We're going to select these three edges, then these three and finally these three. So we're going to select all the edges on the over here except the cross. Now let's go back to the perspective view. Now we're gonna delete these edges. Let's click on backspace or even delete. Now we're gonna work on creating the these edges over here. So to do that, we are gonna use a tool called split polygon tool. Over here in the edit mesh, you're gonna select the tool. It's gonna be over here, split polygon tool. Let's click on it. We are going to create the edges over here. So let me show you. We are going to come over here. We are going to select the vertex over here. Then we are going to select the vertical line. And then the vertex at the other side. Sorry for that. And when you right click, it's going to be over there. That's going to be the edge. So we are going to do the same thing to these vertex. We are going to do two set of edges on both sides. So we are going to select the vertex on the top. Just make sure you are selecting the vertex and not the edge. Let's select the vertical line and finally the vertex over here. And make sure you haven't select the edge on this side, because sometimes it's going to be, you're going to make a mistake and you're going to select to this side. So when you click on 3, you may see that I haven't really done properly over here. So when you see click on 3, it's gonna be showing you that you have done a mistake, kind of like this. So I'm going to click on 1 back again and Control Z, so that I'll be doing it again. Let me click on G so that I may use the same tool. I'm gonna click on the vertex. Sorry again. I'm gonna click on the vertex over here. Then let me click the vertical line and then finally the vertex on the other side and right click. Now when you click on 3, it's gonna make a shape something like that. There's gonna be a base and a curve. Let me click 1 again. Now I'm gonna do the same thing to the to this side over here. So let me click on G and let me select the vertex, then the vertical line, and then finally this vertex on this side. And I haven't really selected properly, so let me do Control Z and select it again. So it could be a pain doing this, but it's the method. And let me select the vertex over here and right click. Let me do it again. Now when you click on 3, you should be seeing a shape like this. It's gonna be two bases and then finally a curve. kind of like a flower pot or something. And we're gonna do the same thing to the bottom. So yeah, you'll have to do the same thing to the bottom. You just have to scroll down like this, and we're gonna click on one. Now we're gonna just create these edges. Let me click on G, and I'm gonna create the edge. Sorry for that. And on the other side, and the final one. So I finished it, and I think I made a mistake here. No, it's okay. Now let me click on 3, and you should be getting this shape kind of like this. So if you're getting this shape, well done. And if you haven't get if you aren't getting this shape, probably you'll have to do it again. So we're gonna work on this shape. With this shape, let's click on 1. Now the next thing we need to do is we're gonna smooth the sphere. So to do that, you'll have to click the smooth option over here. Let's click on smooth, and yeah, right now we are gonna go to the edge tool. I think we are on edge selection tool. Now what we are gonna do is let's come to the top view, just over here. We're gonna come over here, and you have to select this edge over here. So it's gonna be that's this base, and then 2 from the base. So 1 and 2. You have to double select this edge over here. These set of edges you'll have to double select, double click. So you'll be selecting the all the edges over here. So you're gonna do the same thing from the other side. That's this base, 1 and 2. So with shift selected, you'll be double selecting it. So yeah, that's it. And now we are gonna select the one in the middle. So it's gonna be the one over here, double selected with shift selected. And finally we are gonna select the horizontal line. So let's double select it. So now you may see that that's the basketball shape, kind of like over here. That's the plus and then 2 curves. Now we have got it. So we are gonna work with this. Now what we need to do is we are gonna bevel this. So we'll have to come to edit mesh, and then let's click on the bevel option over here. Let's click on the box right next to bevel. So we're gonna give a width of 0.25. So we'll be giving 0.25 width for these edges. So it's gonna be creating double edges over here. So let's click on bevel, and right now we have the double edges. So you may see that the dash 2 edges over here, the curve, the plus, and the other curve. So the next thing we need to do is we are gonna create another set of edges right next to these double edges. So we are gonna go to edit mesh, and then we are gonna use the tool called insert edge loop tool. So we are gonna select it, and then we are gonna select the we are gonna come near the double edges, and we are gonna create the edge right next to it, and the other side as well. And we're gonna do it to the next one, and then over here. If you haven't noticed it properly, you can just rewatch it. And we're gonna do the same thing to the middle one, middle double edges. We're gonna create the edges over here, and then we're gonna create over here. Yeah, that's it. Now now we are gonna work with these. So now you may see that we have created the edges right next to it. Yeah, that's fine. Now let's go to the face selection tool. We are gonna right click and face. Now what we are gonna do is we are gonna double select these faces in the right between the double edges. So we're gonna select one edge, and I think we haven't done it over here. So we're gonna go back to edge tool, We're gonna select, go to edit mesh and insert edge loop tool, and I think we forgot over here. Let's add the edge right here, then right here. Yeah, that's fine. Now let's go back to the polygons tool. We're gonna select the face over here, the face over here. Then with shift selected, we're gonna double click on the face right next to it. So you may see that all the faces are selected. Yeah, and we are going to select the face over here in the middle one. We're going to select it and double select the other one. So you may see that all the faces are selected. We're going to do the same thing to the other side. Select the face and then double click on the face next to it. So all the faces are selected, connected to it. And the final one is the horizontal line. We're gonna select it, double select the other face so that all the faces are selected. So if you have it, it's gonna be really perfect. We're gonna just resize it. Now let's click on R, or we're gonna go to this scale tool, and we're gonna just scale it down a bit. We'll have to select it, scale it down a bit, just a little, not much, a little bit. And then let's go let's click on 3, and we are gonna just we're gonna click on 3, and then let's we're gonna 3, and let's go to object mode, so that you may see that the basketball shape is right over here. You may see that the curves are, it's perfect. So this is gonna be our basic basketball shape. And you may even resize it if you need. If you want, you can just select back the face, and you can click on R, and maybe you can reshape it more. The depth, you can change it as you wish. But this is going to be our basic basketball shape. We're going to work on that, but I'm going to end the video right here, because I want to do the texturing on the other video. Thanks for watching, guys. Leave a like and click on the subscribe button and on the notification bell for weekly content. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. See you later.